We like to talk about things that matter, like your money. So retirement is something that we all have to think about sooner or later.
Yeah, but for one generation, really, that point is fast approaching. Senior financial planner, our friend Alex Manassa with Zarka Financial is here now to give some tips on the baby boomers right now, and if you fall into that category, and how to help really avoid when you're trying to save. And right now, we keep saying, be patient, because with our 401s, all this stuff, our financial situation going down, 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 people keep saying, don't worry, ride it out, it'll be fine by the time you want to retire. But what about the people who are ready to retire and their money they keep losing?
Well, exactly what we're talking about here is what you see a lot of financial articles everywhere now, all about the baby boomer retirement crisis. That is the topic of
topic du jour.
Baby boomer retirement crisis. There's a reason why these articles are coming out right now. So this, as a starting point, let's talk about baby boomers. Do you know who baby boomers are?
Like what are the age?
Baby boomers were, it was that baby boom the U.S. experienced right after the war. Technically, it's people born between 1946 and 1964. It's an 18-year period. That was the baby boom, okay? And guess what the peak year of the baby boom was? It was 1957. Mm. More births than in the history of the United States. The peak year of the baby boom was 1957. So guess how old somebody is turning this year if you were born in 1957? The answer is 66. You're turning 66 this year. So what we're seeing is this massive peak of these baby boomers retiring, okay, right now. We're at the very peak of it, right? More than half already have, but we're at the peak of it right now. And the problem is that we're seeing a crisis where they don't have enough for retirement. Mm-hmm. Now, there's a lot of reasons for that, but that's what we're facing right now. Okay, so if we talk about why that is, okay, there's a lot of reasons. Number one is the decline of traditional pensions. Everyone's having to do your own thing now with your 401ks and your IRA.
Right.
That's a big one, okay? Then a lot of people were scared away from the markets in 2008, you know, the Great Recession. Not to mention COVID. Okay, people have been, in fact, not just baby boomers, a lot of investors have been scared. They've got cash just sitting, you know, off to the sideline because they've been afraid of the markets. Mm-hmm. Not only that, but interest rates have been so low, they haven't been earning anything on those assets. So these are all reasons why they're looking at a crisis. In fact, the average baby boomer retiring only has about $150,000 saved in investments. That might, I don't know if that sounds like a lot to you or not, but that's enough for about $500 a month in retirement
income.
It sounds
like a lot, but it's going to go fast.
That's
right. When you're trying to live on that.
That's right. And about half don't have anything at all. $150 is an average. Okay, an average.
Half of baby boomers don't have anything saved.
Right. They're just going to live on Social Security. That's going to be it. So, you know, an average can be deceiving. Kind of like between the three of us and LeBron James, what's the average number of NBA points that we've scored in our careers? Okay. Well, it's 10,000. Okay. That's a lot of points, okay? But one person in an average can really skew the number.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what's going on right now with the baby boomers, and that's why these articles are everywhere.
Okay, well, we have about a minute left. You're 65, and you're looking to make some good choices here. What should we do?
One thing to do is get the money off the sidelines. This isn't just baby boomers. This is all investors. If you've been scared about the markets with what's been going on, the volatility, get your money off the sidelines. There's a lot of good options now that are a lot better than a year ago, especially in fixed income. You can be a conservative fixed income fund, a bond fund, you can earn 5, 6, 7%, you know, monthly yield, which was not available just a year ago because the interest rates have gone up so much.
So that's something safe to invest in that you're going to get a much better
reasonably
return.
Safe. There are even guaranteed options that are paying you 4.5, 5, 5.5%. But reasonably safe, yes. And it's time to start thinking about that. So that's a big thing to do. Also for everybody, if you're not quite at the retirement stage yet, think about maxing out your 401ks and your IRAs. We talk about this all the time. Be aware of the higher limits. You can save more than ever in your 401ks and your IRAs, and do some planning. So those are the three things I would suggest. You know, get money off the sidelines. Talk to somebody if you want to about what your options are. And do more planning and max out where you can. Control what you can control.
True.
Talk to the experts. Lots of options there. And otherwise, you're going to have to keep working. That or move down south and buy a house in the hills with your 100. That's lots of things.
Live on a boat.
Thank you. Alex, pleasure. So, Social Security, it'll be there for you. We promise. So if you have financial questions or need more information on Zarka Financial Services, you can head to our website, foxa.com, and click on Seen on TV.